Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to you. Sponsors, prize givers,
teachers, family and friends of the contestants and lovers of good music. I'm Margaret Throsby and I'm delighted to be here in this beautiful concert hall. I haven't been here for a while and it is the most magnificent place. I'm your compere for the night for the 2017 IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition Finals Concert. But before we begin, I wish to acknowledge the traditional inhabitants of the land on which we stand, the Gurungai Nation, their spirits and their ancestors. Tonight, our finalists have the exciting opportunity to sing with the Opera Australia Orchestra, who gave the evening that great start with the Brahms Academic Festival Overture. And although the focus will be on the singers this evening, of course, I think it's worth taking a minute to consider the incredible musicians on stage. The OAO is the busiest of all Australian orchestras. They give something like 250 performances every year. Their knowledge of classical and operatic repertoire is unrivaled, and we are indeed honoured to have their experience on hand to assist our finalists in giving their best performances. This evening, the orchestra is being conducted by Nicholas Milton. Since 2001, Nicholas has been Chief Conductor and Artistic Director of the Willoughby Symphony Orchestra in Sydney, and since 2007, Chief Conductor and Artistic Director of the Canberra Symphony Orchestra. He's also Chief Conductor of the Innviertler Symphony Orchestra of Austria, and General Music Director and Chief Conductor of the State Opera House in Saarbrücken in Germany. And next year, as if that's not enough, he'll be making his debut at one of the most important opera houses in the world, the Deutsche Oper in Berlin. So a round of applause, please, for the incredibly busy man. It's only through the generosity of Dr. Haruhisa Handa, who's well known, of course, to all of us, Australian opera goers particularly, through his continuing support of the Handa Opera on Sydney Harbour every summer and the International Foundation of Arts and Culture, that the singers might enjoy this privilege of performing with the Opera Australia Orchestra. Unfortunately, Dr. Handa couldn't be here tonight, but we do welcome from Japan his representative, Ms. Midori Mizayaki, Director of his International Affairs. So please pass on our grateful thanks to Dr. Handa for his support over an extraordinary 20 years. And we'd like to also welcome our special guest, Sir John Key, former Prime Minister of New Zealand and patron of the International Foundation for Arts and Culture. We'll hear from Sir John a little later in the evening. This year we had 68 entrants from Australia and New Zealand who participated in rigorous heats around the country. Expat Australian and NZ singers were given the opportunity to be heard also in London. From those heats, 11 talented young singers progressed through to the semi-finals last month at the Independent Theatre in North Sydney, and the finalists tonight have also had an exciting opportunity of working with and being mentored by national adjudicator Catrin Johnsson in a public masterclass with the respected accompanist and vocal coach David Harper. Performances from both the semi-finals and the masterclass can be seen on the singing competition's YouTube channel, and I believe it's had something like 900,000 views already. On the first day of the semi-finals, Catrin also worked with the 11 semi-finalists in a workshop titled The Singing Actor, which is sort of self-explanatory. It focused on how to apply the actor's craft to singing, which is so crucial in opera. A hallmark of the ASC is the caliber of our adjudicators. From the teams of professionals that oversee the heats around the country and overseas, to the panels that adjudicate the semi-finals and the finals, our adjudicators generously give their time and the benefit of their experience in carefully assessing the needs as well as the talents of the contestants. You can review their impressive credentials on the competition's website. The complete finals program, by the way, can also be found there. I'll introduce you to the adjudication panel now, who are seated, seated just up at the halfway up the hall there, and I'd ask you to hold your applause until the end of the introductions. This year's national adjudicator, Catrin Johnsson, is a performance teacher in voice at the University of Auckland, a vocal consultant for Voices NZ Chamber Choir and the Auckland Chamber Choir, and co-director of the New Zealand Singing School. Catrin is also an accomplished organist who began her professional career at the age of 15. And joining her this evening are the internationally acclaimed Swiss soprano Noëmi Nadelmann, the celebrated Icelandic baritone Olafur Sigurdarson. Olafur is proudly supported by the Australian government through the Department of Communications and the Arts and the government of the Federal Republic of Germany, who are represented tonight by their Deputy Consul General, Mr. Jorgen Kutsals. Our next adjudicator is Dr. Narelle Yeo, Director in Residence at the Sydney Conservatorium of Music, where she also teaches stagecraft and voice to graduate and undergraduate students. And the final adjudicator is Raff Wilson, Artistic Administrator of the Sydney Symphony Orchestra. So please welcome our adjudicators tonight. And you, sitting here in the audience tonight, you can also play your part. We're inviting you to vote for your favourite singer. So just attend to this. Be sure you subscribe to our newsletter when you cast your vote at interval. So voting for that will be at interval. By then you will have heard all our contestants, so you can be in the draw to win a fabulous prize. But I think we've had enough talk, so let's get in our attention to the real reason that we're all here tonight, the five extraordinary voices of our finalists. Our first performer this evening is 25-year-old tenor Damian Arnold from New South Wales. Damian has a Bachelor of Music in Performance from the Sydney Conservatorium. He lists a diverse range of musical idols, from superstar tenor Jonas Kaufmann to rock legend Eddie Vedder. As much as we might like to hear a little Pearl Jam, we're not going to hear that tonight. Tonight, Damian will be singing Don Jose's Flower Song from Bizet's Carmen. In this heart-rending aria, Don Jose shows Carmen the flower that she threw to him when they first met and confesses how its fading scent sustained his love during his weeks in prison. So please, welcome to sing Bizet's Flower Song, Damian Arnold.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dave and Damian, for a moving opening to tonight's singing. What a beautiful aria that is. Our next singer is Daniel Carison, 24-year-old baritone from Victoria. Daniel has a Bachelor of Music from the Melbourne Conservatorium. He says that he knew from a very young age that he wanted to be a performer and that he's long been renowned, get this, in his family, for hogging the dance floor at family celebrations and leaping on tables to perform. We considered it, but we thought we might get him to stand on the stage instead of a table. Tonight, he will sing from Rossini's William Tell, a very famous aria, which it's a very moving baritone aria from Act 3, Sois-y mobile. Here, in this only aria in the whole opera, William Tell urges his son, Jemmy, to stay still while his father performs archery's most famous feat, the shooting of an apple on top of his head. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Daniel Carison to sing Sois-y mobile. Daniel Carison, Sois-y mobile, Rossini, beautiful. Our third singer comes from Western Australia, Paull-Anthony Keightley, 25-year-old bass baritone, graduate of Manhattan School of Music and the Western Australian Academy of Performing Arts, WAPA, as we know it. His journey into opera began at a young age when, to combat a stutter, his speech pathologist suggested taking singing lessons, and the rest is history. Tonight, Paull-Anthony will perform O Lovely Scenes Again I See You from Bellini's La Sonnambula. In this aria, Count Rodolfo speaks to himself of the days of his youth when all was tranquil and serene. He regrets that he'll never be able to experience those days again. Please welcome Paull-Anthony Keightley from Western Australia to sing Vivra Viso O Luoghi Ameni by Bellini. Beautiful, Paull-Anthony from Western Australia. Filipe Manu is a 24-year-old tenor from New Zealand. Filipe holds a Bachelor of Music and a postgraduate diploma with distinction from the University of Waitako, where he studied under the direction of the legendary Dame Malvina Major. Though Filipe admits that he first started singing lessons as a way of getting out of class at school, he is no stranger to hard work. He not only is focused on his career, he also volunteers with a charity in New Zealand that gives free books to needy schools. Tonight, Filipe will be performing Fato Inferno from Handel's Rodelinda. So please welcome Filipe Manu to sing this beautiful aria by Handel from Rodelinda.
regno monaco fastoso non trovo riposo. Non trovo riposo. Sotto l'ombra di porpo dai d'oro non trovo riposo. Sotto l'ombra di porpora e d'oro. Pastorello d'un povero armento pur dorme contento. Pur dorme contento sotto l'ombra d'un faggio d'alloro. Pur dorme contento pastorello d'un povero armento. Pur dorme contento sotto l'ombra d'un faccio, d'un faccio d'alloro. Pur dorme contento sotto l'ombra d'un faccio d'alloro.
Grimoaldo's recitative and aria from Rodelinda by Handel. It's beautiful. And that was Filipe Manu from New Zealand. Our final performer and the only female singer tonight is Shikara Ringdahl. Shikara is a 25-year-old mezzo from Queensland. She holds a Bachelor of Music from the Queensland Conservatorium, Griffith University. She says that she's wanted to be an opera singer since the age of 9, when she heard her father's CD of Charlotte Church and was convinced she could do better. Her first piece this evening is a beautiful song called The Swimmer by Edward Elgar. It has at its heart, an Australian connection, because the words are from a poem written by the Australian poet Adam Lindsay Gordon. In this song, the swimmer is buffeted by the sea, but the resounding message is that love lasts and outlasts even storms and the sea. Please welcome to sing The Swimmer by Elgar, Shikara Ringdahl.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shikara, for that wonderful performance, Elgar's The Swimmer. This seems an opportune time to tell you just a little bit about the history of the competition. The Australian Singing Competition was established by solicitor Roland Gridiger to realise the vision of one of his clients, dedicated singing teacher Marianne Marty Frisdane. Over the years, many luminaries have given their expert advice on how to structure the competition and have also helped with the development and acquisition of valuable scholarships. It's through the support of many people this year that we're offering nearly $200,000 worth of prizes and opportunities. The Australian Singing Competition enriches the quality of music in Australia, there's no doubt about that. It's been operating for 36 years and it's administered by Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited. Over 2,000 singers have participated in the competition and have had the benefit of being heard and interviewed by eminent professionals. Of the winners of the primary prizes, the majority are pursuing careers here in Australia and overseas, as are the many other singers who've shared well over $3 million worth of prizes or valuable opportunities. Of course, none of this would be possible without the support of our amazing sponsors and prize givers, I know many of whom are in the audience tonight. But let's get back to the music now, and we're going to hear each of the singers again. And so for his final item tonight, Damian Arnold will sing Il Mio Tesoro from Don Giovanni by Mozart. In this aria, Don Ottavio, a young nobleman, wants to assure his beloved fiancée, Donna Anna, that he intends to secure vengeance for her against the man who murdered her father. Ladies and gentlemen, to sing Il Mio Tesoro by Mozart, Damian Arnold.
Non ci voglio tornare, sì, con te.
Bravo. Lovely to hear Damian singing that beautiful aria. Next, we're hearing again Daniel Carison, whose second piece, Mirth and Gaiety, comes from an opera by Lortzing called Der Wildschütz. Like all Lortzing's work, this is based on an opera based on disguise, confusion and misunderstanding. It sounds like opera, doesn't it? With all the basic elements, really, of a great comic opera. In this aria, Count Eberbach sings of his delight in being alive as he prepares to celebrate his birthday. So please welcome back to the stage Daniel Carison.
Langes Leben, so schallt's vom Mund der Gäste. Doch wünsch ich mir daneben das Köstlichste, das Beste. Heiterkeit und Fröhlichkeit, ihr Götter dieses Lebens, euch zu sehen, zu erfliehen, ist das Ziel des Strebens. O, du holde Seligkeit, die des Menschen Welt erfreut, Jugend ruf ich aus, ziehe nieder. Das Geleite. Hübsche Mädchen, hübsche Frauen, kann ich euch nur immer schauen. Holde Sterne meines Lebens, mir ruft nie hinein die Vergebens. Doch durch Liebe nicht allein zieht die Freude bei mir ein. Durch die Liebe nicht allein zieht die Freude bei mir ein. Singt der Abend nieder, dann im Kreis der Brüder, wenn Champagner winket, wenn man Jugend trinket, dann ertönen meine Sänge bei der lauten frohen Klänge. Heiterkeit und Fröhlichkeit, ihr Götter dieses Lebens, euch zu sehen, zu erfliehen, ist das Ziel des Strebens. O, du holde Seligkeit, die
Daniel Carison. Our next piece is, this is Daniel Carison next. That was what we heard just then, which I'm getting a bit confused about. That was from Der Wildschütz by Lortzing. Our next piece is Fear No More, the Heat of the Sun, to be sung by Paull-Anthony Keightley, written by the British composer Gerald Finzi. These words are none other by none other than William Shakespeare. They come from a song cycle, which is called Let Us Garlands Bring. Fear No More, the Heat of the Sun. It explores love and the passage of time. So please welcome Paull-Anthony Keightley to sing Finzi's Let Us Garlands Bring.
To dust.
What a gorgeous song that is by Finzi, Let Us Garlands Bring. Next we have Filipe Manu singing A Mes Amis Quel Jour de Fête from The Daughter of the Regiment by Donizetti. The Daughter of the Regiment, it's like a rom-com in today's language, a sweet romantic comedy with lots of vocal pyrotechnics, lots of opportunities for the singers to show off. In this aria, Tonio has been made a member of the Grenadiers. He approaches some of the members and explains that he's joined the regiment because he loves the regiment's daughter, Marie. Please welcome Filipe Manu to the stage to sing A Mes Amis, Quel Jour de Fête from The Daughter of the Regiment.
Je vais marcher sur votre rabat. L'amour qui m'a tourné la tête, désormais, me condamnera. À quel bonheur, oui, mes amis, je vais marcher sur votre rabat, je vais marcher sur votre rabat. Oui, ça, pour qui je respire à mes vœux derniers sourire et ce doux espoir de bonheur trouble ma raison et mon cœur n'a mes amis, quel jour de fête! Je vais marcher sous votre pas. Ah, mes amis, quel jour de fête! Je vais marcher sous votre pas. Je vais marcher sous votre pas. Je vais marcher. Mes amis, je vais marcher sous votre pas.
Thank you, Filipe. Well, to finish this evening's competition, another appearance from Shikara Ringdahl, who will be presenting, she's taking us this time to an opera by Bellini called I Capuleti e I Montecchi, The Capulets and the Montagues. In this aria, Romeo pleads with Giulietta's father to let him marry her and accept him as a new son. So please welcome back to the stage Shikara Ringdahl. What a fabulous way to end the competition. Thank you, Shikara. Now, while everyone else is relaxing at interval, the adjudicators will be working hard deciding who will win what. Perhaps now, as they depart to tackle their task, it's a good time to warmly thank them with a round of applause. Noëmi Nadelmann, Olafur Sigurdarson, Narelle, Raff Wilson, and National Adjudicator Catrin Johnsson. Please join me in thanking them. Ladies and gentlemen, the Opera Australia Orchestra has been supporting the finalists through, it's really the pressure of competing at this level. The Opera Australia Orchestra is 50 years old this year. They're celebrating 50 years of excellence, formed in 1967 as the Sydney Elizabethan Trust Orchestra, later known as the Australian Opera and Ballet Orchestra. The OA Orchestra has earned an international reputation as an opera orchestra of the highest calibre. They'll be back after interval with another thrilling performance, but Nicholas Milton and orchestra, thank you very much. Now, some of you are long-time supporters of the Australian Singing Competition. Some are friends and family of the performers tonight, and some of you are new additions to the audience, so we welcome you. But all of you can be in the draw to win a beautiful Nespresso coffee machine, minus that handsome man, by voting for your favourite singer tonight and by subscribing to our mailing list using one of the forms which you'll find outside in the foyer. Whether you win the machine or not, you will also, of course, always be the first to hear the latest news from the Australian Singing Competition, which is a win in itself. So if you could please vote early in the interval, as soon as you go out, vote, and then you can have a drink or whatever, and then we can make sure that we have a winner at the time of the prize giving. But for now, refreshments can be purchased in the foyer, and please return in 20 minutes for the conclusion of the program and the announcement of the winners of all the prizes, and there are a lot of them, and especially the announcement of the 2017 Marianne Marty Scholarship winner. So enjoy interval, see you after interval.
Col cavaliere
That's a perennial favourite, isn't it? Largo al factotum from The Barber of Seville by Rossini, and it was performed by Sitiveni Talei, who's an ASC alumnus. He won this competition, the Marianne Marty Scholarship, in 2008. Fabulous to have him back on stage, really. Before we hear this beautiful orchestra in action again, let me just take a moment to tell you a little about Music and Opera Singers Trust Limited, which we call MOST for short, which administers the Australian singing competition. MOST doesn't just help singers, it also administers the ABC Young Performers Awards, which will open entries in November this year, the Rona Tranby Award and Collection that enables the recording of Aboriginal oral histories of their elders, and the Opera Awards for professional opera singers. With all these initiatives and what they have in common is that they provide opportunities for talented Australians, opportunities that sometimes lead to extraordinary lives and extraordinary careers. Well, now we're having a change of pace, I think, aren't we, Nicholas? Nicholas Milton and the Opera Australia Orchestra are about to perform for you the absolutely beautiful overture from Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet. It's said that Tchaikovsky wrote the overture while he himself was grieving over a lost love. The inspiration seems to have paid off. In this piece, he somehow boils the whole tragic story down into only 20 minutes. So I invite you to sit back and enjoy Nicholas Milton and the Opera Australia Orchestra performing Tchaikovsky's overture to Romeo and Juliet.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Thank you. Beautiful. Now we have a special surprise for you. As I've already mentioned, we've been lucky enough to welcome to our adjudication panel this year the acclaimed Icelandic baritone Olafur Sigurdarson, who is in Australia as part of a cultural exchange between the governments of Australia and Germany. Since 2008, Oli, and he asked me to call him Oli, has been a principal soloist in the ensemble of the State Opera House of Saarland, and he's appeared in leading roles and in concert engagements throughout Europe and around the world. Well, his adjudication duties are fulfilled, and I'm delighted to say that he's going to perform for us. He'll sing A Paggio from Falstaff by Verdi. Falstaff is here singing about honour, the word honour. Honour, he says, is nothing but a word. It means nothing after life is over and cannot heal broken bones or wounds. So please give a very warm welcome to, all the way from Iceland, Olafur Sigurdarson.
C'è dell'aria che va, bel costrutto. L'onore lo può sentir chi è morto. No, vive sol coi vivi, neppure. Perché ha torto lo colcan le lusinghe, lo colonne, lo coglio, l'amor ma le calunnie. E per me non ne voglio, no, non ne voglio, no. Tornare a voi, furfanti, o
alteso troppo e mi dispiaccio. Ola, lesti, lesti, al galoppo, il capesto sai bene mi sta. Lesti, 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 al galoppo, al galoppo. Avi, 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 pirico, 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 pirico.
What a voice. Nicholas Milton and the Opera Australia Orchestra have given the singers the best kind of preparation, guiding them so ably through the rehearsals as well as in this, the finals concert. It's a privilege for these young singers. They talk about it backstage, I have to say, how fantastic it is for them to sing with an orchestra, because when you think about it, they're mostly singing by themselves in their practice rooms. So tonight is a very special night for them. So please thank Nicholas Milton and the Opera Australia Orchestra. Ladies and gentlemen, the ASC has a strong commitment to learning and development through specially designed education programs. Last year, it launched its artistic development program under the direction of the Australian soprano Emma Matthews, and we're just coming to the end of the first incredible year. All finalists in the ASC are invited to enrol in the program and are matched with an appropriate mentor. The mentor works with the singer over 12 months and might suggest further training and activities tailored to their individual needs. Nothing like a mentor in life, is there? This program is only made possible through the generous contributions of Gay and Roy Woodward and Maria and John Hepworth, and we thank them sincerely for their commitment to our singers. MOST is an organisation that loves to innovate and to recognise great achievement in the arts. In keeping with this mission, last year MOST established a new accolade, the MOST Achievement Award, awarded to individuals who demonstrate the highest ideals and qualities, whose contributions promote the positive evolution of their industry, who support their artistic community, and who contribute to the cultural life of Australia. Recipients are nominated and selected by a panel of industry peers convened by MOST. I'd like now to invite to the stage Geoffrey Black, Chair of the Advisory Committee and a former Marty winner, by the way, to announce this year's winner of the MOST Achievement Award. Geoffrey Black.
Good evening, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am in the somewhat happy position of knowing to whom this award will be given this evening. Additionally, I am sure, by the conclusion of my introduction, many of you will know to whom I am referring. The recipient of MARS 2017 began the professional career in 1975, joining the National Opera Company, Australian Opera, as it was then known. Having studied at the Sydney Conservatorium, principal study piano, their services as an accompanist for singing lessons, recitals, etc., were already being called upon on a regular basis. Their love of beautiful singing and the developing of the craft and technique required to reach the giddy heights of becoming an outstanding recitalist and opera singer had their genesis here. During their time with Opera Australia, they have assumed a number of positions: principal repetiteur, head of music, artistic administrator, and finally, Opera Australia's director of music administration. During their time with OA, they worked with many distinguished singers and conductors. Both parties have been privileged to draw upon an exceptional musician's ear and an unstinting, unrelenting commitment to excellence in both preparation, whether for a specific role or the preparation of an opera in its entirety, leading to its fruition and outstanding performances which followed. The recipient is considered one of Australia's finest vocal coaches and accompanists. The artists with whom they have accompanied and coached reads like a who's who of not just singers renown here in Australia, but internationally. Dame Joan Sutherland, Håkon Haugegaard, Bryn Terfel, Wilhelmina Fernandez, Sir Thomas Allen, Desiree Rancatore, Teddy Tahu Rhodes, Yvonne Kenny, Dennis O'Neill, Kathleen Battle, Barbara Bonney, and so the list goes on. I know in my own personal experience, having worked with this distinguished musician, one knew that one had to come prepared to every session because their commitment to the sort of preparation and excellence that is required within this incredibly demanding industry means that you need to be demanding more of yourself. And it was perhaps this quality that sets this person apart within the Australian landscape. Their continuing commitment to the art of bel canto, fidelity to language, and the ingesting of the true emotional intent, whether it is of a lead melody, art song, or operatic character, is as razor sharp as it ever once was. The harsh realities of a demanding industry, I mentioned before, and therefore demanding of an artist more than they feel that they are capable, has ever been their philosophy. Therefore, it is with great pride I can announce that this year's recipient of Mars 2017 is Miss Sharon Kamali AM. These are, in fact, the certificate and the medallion that Sharon will receive. However, unfortunately, work commitments prevent her being here in person. However, we do have a response from Sharon from Europe. I feel very honoured to have been named the 2017 Most Achievement Award, and I'm disappointed that my work commitments in Europe prevent me from joining you at the finals concert this evening to receive this award in person. The IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition has provided incredible opportunities for so many of our outstanding young singers since its inception in 1982. Many of the participants have gone on to have successful careers both in Australia and internationally, and I am proud to have had a long association with so many of the singers who have been involved. I am deeply grateful that this award has recognised and celebrates my contribution, passion, and unwavering commitment to excellence. I will continue to share my experiences with this wonderful profession. Miss Sharon Kamali.
Thanks very much, Geoffrey. That is a wonderful award to a wonderful musician. That's fantastic. It's also wonderful to know that there are such organisations as IFAC and benefactors like Dr. Handa, providing financial help for the sort of talent we've been privileged to witness tonight. Dr. Handa has also asked his Director of International Affairs, Ms. Midori Miyazaki, to speak on his behalf. So would you please welcome her to the microphone.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you once again for your great support for this evening. And it's been a great honor and an immense pleasure for IFAC to be involved in this singing competition for the last two decades. Dr. Handa, unfortunately, is not here tonight, and I am sincerely saddened that he doesn't get to see this wonderful occasion and hear the wonderful voices that your region produces, but he sends you his best regards, and his support has been strong and continues to be strong. So I hope that with the wonderful results that we are going to see tonight, that his enthusiasm towards his support to Australia and this region continues. But in the meantime, I just first of all want to recognize the incredible talent that this region produces. And we, as you know, have been supporting opera in Australia and the arts in Australia for a long time, and it's just a sheer pleasure for us to be associated with your immense talent here in this region. But tonight, I have a very special person who is now representing us. He is Sir John Key, former Prime Minister of New Zealand, and I do know him because he was, or he is, one of the most popular persons and personalities in this region, and we're immensely grateful that he's now supporting us as well, and I hope that you will, and he will, support us moving forward in being associated with this wonderful occasion that you host every year. I'd like to invite him to speak, say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, Midori. Well, talking about Sir John Key, through the International Foundation for Arts and Culture, Dr. Handa supports many causes around the world. He's given financial assistance to this competition over several decades. And so it's with great pleasure that I now call on the Right Honourable Sir John Key, former Prime Minister of New Zealand and patron of IFAC, to say just a few words. Please welcome him.
Well, thanks very much and good evening. On behalf of Dr. Handa, it's great to be here as his patron for IFAC. I know that Dr. Handa would have loved to have been here this evening because he himself is a wonderful singer, and he thoroughly enjoys the passion and the spirit of these singing competitions. He's been a long-term supporter of the arts and, of course, of singing. And one of the great passions of Dr. Handa is to see young people to live out their dreams and to succeed and to really believe in their passion. And that's one of the reasons why he's been a supporter of the singing competition and why we see him do so many things around the world. I first got to meet Dr. Handa when I was Prime Minister of New Zealand, and he was involved in giving some support back to the people of Christchurch after the earthquakes. And so one of the things he did as a real act of kindness was to support a golf tournament that saw Lydia Ko come back and win that golf tournament. So that's when I first got to meet him. And since I've been involved in a number of the organisations he's in, we've been everywhere from Cambodia, seeing the great work he's doing for orphanages and for universities and hospitals he's supported for nearly 20 years there. So he has a wide range of interests and an incredibly generous heart. And what he does in relation to Opera Australia and to the singing competition is a very small part of what he's involved in. Finally, just to all of the singers this evening, I think you'll agree with me that they were truly magnificent. Each and every one of them has a great career in front of them. I'm glad I'm not a judge, because with four Aussies and one Kiwi, I'd have to vote for the Kiwi. That's just pure partisanship. But I think all five of them really entertained us this evening and showed us what talents that they have. So thank you for allowing me to be part of the singing competition, to see it this evening. As I say to all of them, congratulations. There's some very proud people in the audience. There can only be one winner, but I think you'll agree that opera is on a great footing here in Australasia, and the singing competition leads to that. So well done.
Thank you very much, Sir John. Well, it's time to get excited because Catrin Johnsson is waiting in the wings with the results of the adjudicator's deliberation. So please welcome her, Catrin Johnsson.
Ladies and gentlemen, a warm thank you to you all for being here this evening. It is such a great honour and privilege for me to be this year's National Adjudicator of the IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition. I feel so very blessed to have been part of it. A musician's career is one long succession of extraordinary adventures, and this adventure I will always treasure. Congratulations to the finalists. They can hear me, so I will talk to them. I feel so proud of you all, and I want to thank you from my heart for sharing your music and your stories with us. It's clear to me that each of you has much beauty within. We hear that. I wish you every good thing on your future paths. Why do we sing? We sing to give our soul a voice. We sing to share, to reach, to stir, to protest, to humor, to love, to soothe, to heal. We soften people. We change their lives sometimes. Go well, my friends. I believe in you all. Please give the singers a warm hand. Thank you to Maestro Nicholas Milton and the Opera Australia Orchestra. It was so beautiful. Please give them a big hand. And please give a round of applause to our fantastic compere, Margaret Throsby. Thank you. Thank you to the wonderful panel of adjudicators here tonight. What a great lineup of high caliber musicians from different parts of the world. Thank you also to all my other fellow adjudicators in Australia, in the UK, and in New Zealand. It's been so enriching working with such enthusiastic and highly skilled colleagues. Also, thank you to the tireless team here in Sydney who run this competition, and deepest thanks also to Roland Gridiger. The team asked me to remind you all that the Marty is awarded on potential. The panel's choice may not be your choice, but let's all part as friends anyway. In the end, if we react positively or negatively, it's a good thing because it means that it matters to us. Music matters. Art matters. A final word from me to these fine young singers today. Make music every day. Give people joy. Shine your light where it's needed. Thank you.
I know that they're pacing up and down, so let's bring them on stage. Would you please welcome back, and don't clap just yet, Damian Arnold, Daniel Carison, Paull-Anthony Keightley, Filipe Manu, and Shikara Ringdahl. Congratulations to all of you for giving us such a beautiful concert tonight. Now, Catrin, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
We're up at the pointy end, aren't we?
Okay.
In recognition of reaching this stage of the competition, the five finalists are each awarded the Opera Australia Prize, an opportunity to attend rehearsals in Melbourne or Sydney, observing an opera throughout the stages of its production. The first individual prize is the Christine Leaves Award, 30 hours of publicist consultation, business and promotional planning over a five-year period. It also includes the creation of business cards and or a basic website. And the winner of this award is...
Paull-Anthony Keightley.
The David Harper Award, 10 lessons with the internationally renowned vocal coach and accompanist David Harper, has been won by...
Damian Arnold.
The WAPA International Art Song Academy Prize. Now, this is a scholarship to attend and participate in the next West Australian Academy of Performing Arts International Art Song Academy, including flights, accommodation and masterclasses with internationally renowned accompanist Graham Johnsson and other international guests. This exciting prize goes to...
Shikara Ringdahl.
The Canberra Symphony Orchestra Prize, an engagement to perform with the Canberra Symphony Orchestra, and this one has been won by...
Paull-Anthony Keightley.
The Sydney Philharmonia Choirs Prize, which is a professional engagement to perform with the Sydney Philharmonia Choirs next year, and it's awarded to...
Daniel Carison.
The Sydney Symphony Orchestra Award, which is an engagement to perform with the Sydney Symphony, awarded to...
Shikara Ringdahl.
The Bel Canto Voice Program Scholarship. Now, this is an opportunity to attend the Audition Training Opera Program held by the Bel Canto Summer Voice Program in Munich in 2018. The winner will also receive $2,500 Haas Award to assist with travel expenses. These prizes have been won by...
Daniel Carison.
The International Vocal Arts Institute New York Scholarship. Now, this is a scholarship granting automatic entry to attend the International Vocal Arts Institute Summer School in New York in July of next year. The winner will also receive $3,000 Australian, the Nell Pascal Award, to assist with travel expenses. This exciting prize is awarded to...
Filipe Manu.
The Nellie Apt Scholarship, up to $7,000 to fund travel and accommodation to attend the Israeli Opera Young Artist Program at the Opera Studio in Tel Aviv. This 4 to 5 week program features many projects and coachings and masterclasses and performances and runs from mid-October this year to early June next year. It's been won by...
Shikara Ringdahl.
The Saarbrücken Opera House Prize, which is the opportunity to attend a 3 week program at the State Opera House of Saarbrücken, including opportunities for language coaching, cultural experiences, as well as access to the company, orchestral, rehearsal, performances, and auditions. And this one is sponsored by Nicholas Milton. And it's a wonderful opportunity. And it's been won by...
Shikara Ringdahl.
The Miranda Legacy Prize, which is a grant of up to $8,000 to study the Italian language in Italy, and it's awarded to...
Damian Arnold.
Mm. the Royal Overseas League Arts Scholarship. This includes a cash grant from the Victorian branch of the League, a return flight to the UK, 2 weeks accommodation and hospitality in central London at the Royal Overseas League's private members club, which is called Overseas House. Rosal Arts will also arrange several performance opportunities in London or Edinburgh. And the winner of this popular scholarship is...
Paull-Anthony Keightley.
The Guildhall School of Music and Drama Award is a scholarship for 1 year's study in the postgraduate diploma vocal training course. The winner also receives the $5,000 Pasqualina Lipari Prize, sponsored by V&A Accountants and Business Advisors Adelaide, and these are both awarded to...
Daniel Carison.
And just for a moment, to take the heat off the contestants, we go now to the member of the audience who's won the fabulous Nespresso coffee machine, whose name's been drawn out of a hat under the strictest supervision, and it is...
Gil Kleiner.
Gil Kleiner. Whee! And the most audience, the most audience award goes to?
Filipe Manu.
Finally, just before this year's Marty winner is announced, a big congratulation to Roland Gridiger, Chief Executive Officer, together with the Most team for keeping the competition going all this time, an amazing 36 years in all. So let's give them a hand. So here we go. In addition to the Marianne Marty Scholarship of $30,000, to assist with vocal study or career advancement, the winner will receive these prizes. The audition prize from Lyric Opera of Chicago's Ryan Opera Center, an opportunity to audition for Lyric Opera of Chicago's Professional Artist Development Program, the Patrick G. and Shirley W. Ryan Opera Center in Chicago. The Fine Music 102.5 recording session, which is a one-hour studio recording with our opponents, the Fine Music Station 102.5. They're a fantastic station, I tell you. The Lily Usher Prize Portrait Prize, the portrait painting of the winner in concert dress. The Oral History Award, a taped interview by oral historian Diana Rich, will be recorded and retained within the oral history collection of the National Library of Australia. And... we have it here, a beautiful limited edition sculpture by Drago Cherina, which Roland Gridiger is holding. It's beautiful, isn't it? It's lovely. They win that too. So now, to announce the winner, National Adjudicator Catrin Johnsson, it's over to you.
It is with pleasure that I announce that the 2017 Marianne Marty Scholarship has been won by Filipe Manu.
Not getting away without saying something.
Thank you. Where do I start? Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to just start by saying thank you to the IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition and Madame Marty for providing the scholarship. Without this platform, young singers such as myself and my competitors wouldn't be able to dream of further pursuit in this career. I'd also like to thank my competitors. You know, it's such a great vibe backstage. It makes everything go so much smoother. And Yeah, they're all right to the Kiwi, the one Kiwi in the back. And thank you very much to my fellow competitors. Thank you to Dr. Nicholas Milton and the fantastic Opera Australia Orchestra. It's been an amazing opportunity to work with such a great orchestra. I'd like to thank the adjudicators and most particularly the national adjudicator, Catrin Johnsson. This has been such a fantastic opportunity that we've all learned so much from. Lastly, but by no means least, I'd like to thank my supporters, the Dame Malvina Major Foundation, the Dame Kiritsukanoa Foundation, the New Zealand Opera Foundation. Without their support, I wouldn't be able to be standing here and doing what I love doing. And finally, but not least, to my family, who's come here from New Zealand, and my two brothers that have come here from Melbourne. Malo au pito ho homo bobo kuhiva. It means the world to me that my family's there and support. And it was good to have a sort of nice family reunion before I head overseas. And lastly, thank you to my best friend, but my partner Madison Denoa and the Horsfield family for all the support and generosity. And I guess it's a bit weird because I was just born, even though I'm a Kiwi, I was born in Armidale, in New South Wales. And and when I was young, I had a postcard, and on the postcard was a picture of the Sydney Opera House. And I used to think that was the Armidale Hospital. And I was like, oh, that's a pretty strange looking hospital, but go Armidale. And to be back here now, singing in Sydney, where I would say, where my life began, is sort of, I've sort of done the full circle before I head overseas and continue my career. So thank you, and thank you to everyone associated with this competition. It's been a massive, massive opportunity. Thank you very much.
What a fantastic winner, Filipe Manu. We've got a habit in this country of claiming successful Kiwis as our own. So we can now claim you as one of our own, I think, quite wholeheartedly. Congratulations, all of you. There's that saying at competitions, there can only be one winner, but in fact, they're all winners. They really are all winners to get this far, and they've all gone away with wonderful prizes. So, ladies and gentlemen, we've almost come to the end of the IFAC Handa Australian Singing Competition Finals Concert. I hope you've enjoyed it. We bid farewell with our thanks to Catrin Johnsson and this evening's magnificent performers. Thank you to the singers, to Nicholas Milton, to the Opera Australia Orchestra, to the adjudicators, to the organisers for all the amazing hard work, for the ladies and gentlemen behind the scenes who've been really keeping this thing on the rails tonight. It's just fantastic. I thank you particularly for your enthusiastic response and continued support of the Australian Singing Competition. Thank you to the directors and staff of the Concourse here in Chatswood, and we look forward to your attendance at next year's finals concert. Good night and thank you.